Welcome back, everyone, to Point Click Repeat. I am Alan, and we just found Dr. Carrington's corpse in his office. He was porcupined. I mentioned this before, but for some reason, certain locations, specifically Yvette's office and Dr. Carrington's office, I can't access the save menu. So I actually left Carrington's office from last time out through Yvette's door. And I'm not going to go back in because I think that might trigger something else. So, just so you're aware, there was one thing that I wanted to look at in Yvette's office, but we can do that later, on our way out there. But right now, we actually want to, head to the armory gallery because there was a note about, the Countess, what's happening? Are you floating in the air? Anyway, the Countess is apparently going to meet Ziggy there at 1, so we want to go see what that's all about. Now, we know Ziggy's dead, but does she know that? So, yeah, we're going to want to meet her here, but we need to hide, so we're going to go behind the tapestry. Aha, and it's now 1. There she is. She's got something. And surprise!
Whale. Good evening, Candace.
What are you doing here?
None of your business.
I just happened to be hiding behind the tapestry.
You're lying!
How could you tell?
Nobody just happens to hide behind a museum tapestry.
And nobody just walks around inside a museum late at night with paintings under their arms.
Paintings? Oh, you mean these paintings? I just found them laying around on the floor and I picked them up so no one would step on them.
I don't think so.
You don't think so? Are you accusing me of something, you silly girl?
What do you think?
I think you're a rude girl who needs to learn some manners. The nerve going around accusing people of stealing paintings.
Did I say anything about you stealing them?
Well, of course you did. Don't try to trick me, girl. I've got more tricks than you have brain cells.
One thing I have to ask myself is, why did you bring those paintings to a meeting with Dr. Carrington this time of night?
How did you know I was meeting Dr. Carrington?
I found a note beside his body.
His body?
Mm-hmm.
You talk about him like he was dead.
Yes, he is. Dead as a doorknob. You didn't know about it?
You're trying to trick me again. Dr. Carrington is alive and well and working in his office.
Well, you're right about him being in his office, but he's quite dead, I assure you.
Oh, my God!
And you seem to be a logical murder suspect.
Wait a second! You're not going to pin this one on me! I didn't have anything to do with it. Why would I want to kill him? We've got a perfectly good art burglary scheme going.
Art burglary?
I think I said too much.
Never mind.
If you're trying to convince me that you're not the murderer, you're not doing a very good job of it.
What do I care what you think anyway? You're not a cop.
But I am a reporter, and I could write about you in the newspaper. Of course,
Control.
Your reputation would be ruined, and the police would get very interested in you. But you're tough, so I'm sure you could handle it.
Look, it was just a little deal I worked out with Dr. Carrington. An art forger duplicates the paintings on the wall of the gallery. Then we hang them up in place of the real ones, which we sell to private collectors.
Didn't you think someone would catch on after a while?
Are you kidding? That's the beauty of the plan. When we had replaced all the paintings, we were going to slash them and make it look like someone vandalized the real paintings. No one would ever think we'd go to the trouble of forging paintings just to destroy them. and Carrington is here to see that no one gets too nosy.
Not anymore.
You mean he was here?
I swear I didn't have anything to do with his death. He was my cash cow. I brought him over from Europe just for this reason. Now that's it. I'm not saying any more about it.
You sure said a lot, though. No, oh, there you go. I was like, I think she's supposed to leave. Just sure taking her sweet time. Okay, now I'm pretty sure we can do what I wanted to do with this earlier.
The faceplate on the armor is slightly open, as if something is protruding from the inside of the dark helm.
Oh no!
Dr. Carter's body has been indelicately crammed into the suit of armor. His
filmy
eyes gaze in mute shock. His head is bent at an unlikely angle, and the skin is puckered where the helmet's edges bite into the expanding flesh.
Why would you do this?
It's Dr. Pippin Carter, famous dead archaeologist.
Like, it's such a weird thing. Said, what's his face? Said the coroner took him. And just stuffed him into a suit of armor. Anyway, I think we can head back now. No, oh, there's she's just casual now. There's a couple more convos we need to hear. I think we can go back in here though. Alright, so this is the part that I wanted to look at earlier.
Miss Bo, this is a private office.
Oh, well, I was just looking around. Have you seen this paper cutter? It looks like it has blood on the blade.
Blood? Oh. That's not blood. You got me all excited. It's probably just red ink. But if you're worried about Yvette, I just saw her on the way down to Ernie's office in the basement. She goes down there a lot for some reason.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe she's fond of Ernie?
Yvette is very fond of everyone, my dear. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some business to attend to.
Okay, bye. You don't care that I'm in the private office anymore? Yeah, these are magnifying glass on it.
The red stain on the paper cutter blade could be red ink or blood. Perhaps the last person to use it had an accident?
So, now in case you're wondering, I'm pretty sure what the game is trying to say is that whoever killed Ziggy cut his head off with this paper cutter and then put in the life mask exhibit, which is ludicrous. Either they would have needed to, you know, stab him with the pterodactyl, then lug the paper cutter over there and cut it off, then bring it back to the office, or cut his head off here, then bring his body to the pterodactyl and stab him with the pterodactyl without leaving any other traces. It's pretty silly, but, you know, it's fun. Okay, so I'm pretty sure this is where we'll get another combo.
You hear muffled voices coming.
Oh, Dr. Smith, I appreciate your help so much.
Well, I don't particularly appreciate giving it. I have things to do, Miss Delacroix. Important things.
But surely you can spare the time to help me move my desk, no?
Oh, I suppose. Why do you want to move it anyway?
Oh, there is a terrible stain on the rug. I don't want it to show. We don't have to move the desk very far.
All right. Oh, it's heavy. Oh!
Oh, I am so, so sorry. Did you hurt yourself?
Yes. Oh, no. I'm bleeding. You owe me one, miss.
But of course, Mr. Smith. I'll do anything you say. Anything. Didn't I let you in when you asked? Didn't I keep your secret?
Yes, I suppose you did. And I'm sorry about bleeding on your carpet. At least it'll blend in with the old stain. What is that, anyway?
Oh, it is only strawberry jam.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure I don't want to know, Yvette.
Probably not, Dr. Smith. Now, let's go to your place.
Alright, well, Yvette certainly is talking to a lot of people about a lot of things. And has a lot of secrets. But alas, let us do a save here. I don't know. Yvette, not so delicate. I don't know. I'm not being clever right now. Alright, let's head down downstairs, see what else we can find down there. And hopefully Ernie's in here, not with Yvette. Ah, perfect.
Something I can do for you, Miss Bull?
Yes, I would like to talk to you.
Mr. Leech, can you let me out of this museum? I don't like it in here. People keep dying.
Sorry, Miss Bo. I seem to have lost my door keys.
Oh, I find that very disturbing.
Mm-hmm.
Me too. I can't even let myself out of the building. We're all staying here until I find those keys.
All right, well, let's question about some people.
If that fellow were any more full of himself, he'd rise up and float away like a hot air balloon. The way he carries on, you'd think he discovered Atlantis. Well, I don't see the gent too often. We working class folks don't see the big guys too often, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's fair.
Oh, I guess he's an okay fella. For a cop. I do wish he'd stop leaving those grape stems all over the place, though.
Grape stems? Weird.
Now there's a Weasley little fella. I've heard he's a stool pigeon. That's a dangerous way to make a living. Dr. Miklos is a strange bird, but she's a decent sort all the same. I see her a lot at night working late. Sometimes she invites me in for coffee. She certainly is taken with the plate in my head. She must have looked at the scars a dozen times.
Plate in your head? Interesting.
Miss Delacroix is a wonderful lady, Miss Bo. A delight to work for.
Mm-hmm. I bet she is. Oh, Wolfie.
That fella gives me the willies. He's always hanging around, looking over my shoulder with those suspicious eyeballs of his. Also, to tell you the ugly truth, I just haven't trusted the Germans since the war. That Kaiser guy was a real high hat.
You fought in the Great War, Mr. Leech?
Yes, I did, Miss Bo. I came back with a plate in my head and a chest full of medals, and then I couldn't get a job to save my soul.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Oh, don't let it bother you, Miss Bo. I'm just jawing. I'm doing fine now.
That's good. I like Ernie. Wait, did we just ask about this guy?
He's a quiet little fella. I think he does some accounting for the museum. Seems nice enough.
Okay. Oh, Steve.
Oh, he seems like a nice enough fella. I don't know him too well.
Yeah, me neither. But I kissed him.
The Countess is a quite colorful old dame, isn't she? I can't help liking her.
I like
his
theme too.
He's an intense sort of a gent. He's all bent out of shape about this dagger business, and he hangs around Dr. Carter a lot. He looks ready to blow a blood vessel to me.
What about you?
Why, that's me, Miss Bo. Ernie Leech. I thought you reporters were supposed to have good memories.
No, I wanted to know more about you. You'd seem like the best person to ask about yourself. Oh.
No, I can't say I ever met the man.
Okay, doesn't know anything about Wani Little. Let's see. Maybe... let's go with the burglary.
Mr. Leech, do you have any idea who might have taken the Dagger of Amon-Ra?
I sure don't. Well, I halfway wonder if it wasn't one of those Egyptian fellas. They probably think I took it.
Was the dagger well guarded?
Oh, sure. It was locked up tighter than a drum. Somebody really pulled a fast one.
What were you about to say there? Because that's disturbing. If you're saying what I think you're saying. Anything here that maybe you might be able to shed some light on? Maybe the police file.
Good lord. That fella has a rap sheet a mile long. I hope I never meet up with him. At first, I wasn't sure I'd like it here in this big, spooky old place. But it was so peaceful at night, and there's so many interesting things everywhere. I really enjoy it now.
I don't know if there's anything else we can ask him about.
Do you know much about Egyptology, Mr. Leech?
No, Miss Bo, I really don't. I think it's very interesting, though. I picked up a book about it in the museum shop, but I haven't had time to read it yet.
Okay. Well, I think that's some good info from our buddy Ernie. Let's see if we can go in here now. Haha! Ooh, there's the snake oil.
You pick it up and place it in your purse.
It's the ferret.
It's Olympia's ferret, Daisy.
Hi, Daisy. Don't hurt me. Oh. Sniffing at the trunk. Okay, well.
A full bottle of Dr. Moribund's guaranteed snake oil.
Cool. What's this?
The trunk has a name tag identifying it as part of Carrington's personal luggage. Beside it is another sticker emblazoned with the logo Andrea Doria.
Okay, so that's that trunk we saw at the beginning. So there's probably a corpse in there. Not to spoil anything.
It's but a sack of plaster, happen. Sometimes used for making molds.
Plaster. And I think there's something in the fridge we need. Aha, some
you
meat.
Pick it up and place it in your purse.
Perfect. Okay, that's all we can do in here for now. In case you're wondering, this is locked.
This trunk is locked.
Yeah. In case you're wondering why I didn't just open it. Let's see if Ernie's still in here. Dang it.
Something I can do for you, Miss Bull?
No. I want you to not be in here. Let's see if we leave and come back. Maybe he'll be gone.
This door is locked.
Damn it. Ah, perfect. I'm gonna save it. Ernie's gone.
The intercom crackles and you hear...
Ernie, it's Olympia. The release valve in number 13 seems to be jammed. Take a look at it when you have a chance.
That 13, you say?
You pick it up and place it in your purse.
That's a tool we need. It's a snake catcher.
This curious device is a lasso at the end of a pole. Used for the humane capture of snakes in the wild, or wild snakes, or something like that.
Mm-hmm. and some wire cutters.
You pick it up and place it in your purse.
All good tools to have.
Don't touch it.
Oh, sorry.
Where's the listing?
Oh, this is
what Ernie's index to the stored items in the alcohol vats.
So she was saying vat 13 was clogged.
Current vat contents, alcoholic preservation lab. 1. Koala bears. 2. Turtles. 3. Snakes. 4. Hippo. 5. Ground sloth. 6. Skunks. 7. Loch Ness monster. 8. Ostrich. 9. Lemmings. 10. Unicorn.
What?
11. Creature from the Black Lagoon. 12. Rats. 13. Warthogs. 14. King Edward of Daventry.
Silly. But yeah, so the key thing to note about that is that 13 has warthogs in it. Let's see if we can find Vat 13. I think I remember which one it is.
Vat 11.
Oops.
Something odd is floating in the murky liquid. It appears to be half man and half fish. Or maybe it's just a trick of the light.
Mm-hmm.
Vat 12. Small creatures with long tails are floating in the murky liquid. Vat 13. Indistinct shapes are floating in the murky liquid. None of the creatures are close enough to the glass to see what they are.
Well, that's the one we want, though. That's number 13. So that's the one with King Edward of Daventry. And we'll just stir around and then pull. What's this?
Could it be? Yes. It's heavy. It's shiny. It's real gold. It's got a sharp point at one end. It's the Dagger of Amon Ra.
Dun 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 dun. We found it. I know what you're thinking. Didn't we just solve the mystery? And, well, no.
You pick it up and place it in your purse.
She's just gonna take it.
Boy, the alcohol fumes sure are strong in here.
Yeah. That's the other thing, is if you go search too many vats, I think, like, maybe even more than two, then you pass out and die. So, we're not gonna do that. The dagger. But yeah, we found the dagger. Doesn't mean we know who stole it. And, sure, we could turn into the authorities, but, we want to do some more investigating, so we're keeping it in our purse. Do-do-do. Now that we have the wire cutters, there's a couple things we can get, including... we can get the wire. I think we need to zoom in on it. And this little piece of wire.
Well, this is an...
There we go.
You pick it up and place it in your purse.
Great. And now we can go back to the painting area. I know I just walked past earlier. Yeah, there's supposed to be a way to look at this glinty thing. Oh, maybe it's working this time. Aha!
Inspecting the painting carefully, you note the bloody quality of the red pigment and recall that Bosch was known for the use of human blood in his paintings.
Yuck.
Inspect...
There we go.
This skeleton key is inscribed with eerily articulated markings. The weird orthography of a long-dead tongue. It offers no clue as to what it unlocks. Pandora's box, perhaps?
Don't be silly. This isn't King's Quest. But yeah, we can use the... Actually, I think we can use either the dagger or the bolt cutters, or wire cutters to
With careful use of the wire cutters, you manage to remove the skeleton key without damaging the Bosch painting.
Perfect. Now we have a skeleton key. Now we can go open that trunk. Bloom, 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 bloom. Can finally find out what was in that trunk. If you didn't watch the opening, the intro video, like I did as a kid, it's a lot more surprising. And let's just peer inside.
The trunk has a name tag identifying it as part of Carrington's personal luggage. Beside it is another sticker emblazoned with a...
Yeah, yeah. No! Oh, God! Oh, no! The hell was that? There's nothing like the bugs like better than a little fresh meat. Yeah, so... one of those things where apparently there's a bunch of, like, flesh-eating bugs in there. So you have to, unlock it. And then quickly give them something else that they like. Some other meat. And then they march off with it, all happy with their prize. It's pretty silly.
Oh!
Oh! She's getting less freaked out by the stuff she sees.
A skeleton lies in the trunk, its bones picked clean by the domestic beetles. They've efficiently removed every last shred of flesh, making the skeleton nearly impossible to identify.
Who could it be?
It appears to be a gold pocket watch. It appears to be a gold pocket watch.
Thank you. You have to open it first, I guess.
A close look reveals an inscription on the watch. To Dr. Archibald Carrington III, for your years of dedicated service, many thanks from your staff at the British Museum. You pick it up and place it in your purse.
Oh, it is now 1:45, or 1:45, sorry. Alright, well, so that appears to be the skeleton of Dr. Carrington. So who was the person we thought was Dr. Carrington then? Well, I think we want to go back to sculpture area. There was someone meeting in the armor room at 2, I think. So since it's almost 2, or it's almost 1. Someone meeting there at 1. I can't remember. Pretty sure we need to go to the armor room soon. There might be another convo.
You hear muffled voices coming through the door to Yvette's office.
That's the thing about this game is like, not every time, but most of the time walking into this area, you can trigger a convo in here.
You lied to me.
Oh.
Well, lass, I guess that makes us even. You lied to me.
You had something to do with the dagger burglary.
You've been sleeping with someone else. I saw you go off with that dock worker.
I've never slept with Steve, and the Ziggy fellow, he told me about you and the dagger.
And you believe that little weasel? I've arrested the man more times than I can count.
The Ziggy, I know him a long time. He would not lie to me.
That man had lied to his own mother if someone paid him for it.
Ziggy, he says you were working with the Carrington to steal the dagger.
Lies! You can't be trusting the man. If he wasn't already dead, I'd pound the truth out of him.
Maybe you already did.
Were you sleeping with the little rat then?
Of course not.
You really surprise me, lass. I'd think you grew up on the streets accusing me of burglary like that.
Where I grew up doesn't matter, does it? The important thing is... Wait, did you hear something at the door?
Yeah, I was hearing it too. Keep your voice down then.
Oop. And found out. Quick, run. Yeah, learn more about Yvette and O'Reilly. Seems to be a jealous man. Oh, hi. So yeah, I'm pretty sure there's another meeting here. I can't remember which one it is. Oh, hello. He's gone. But if we hide here, I think it'll trigger. Yes. It is a 2 o'clock one, okay. It's Wolf and Olympia, that's right.
Wolfie, your facial scars are so wonderful. How did you get them?
Fencing, Maestro. As a young man, I would dance with mine Heidelberg friends. We would stop our opponent's saber just before it went through our faces, which would make the scars you see now.
Ah, that is very interesting. You did not use masks to protect your faces?
Nein. That would have been considered unmanly.
You'll have to show me how to do that sometime.
There are many things I can show you, my strudel.
Perhaps we should go somewhere less public, Wolfie.
Oh, yeah. Good idea. Particularly since there's an annoying reporter wandering around the museum. That is not something I would have allowed if I was running things here.
Give it time, Wolfie. Perhaps you will be running things here someday, if I have anything to say about it.
Oh? What can you do?
There are ways, but come, let us speak of these things in more privacy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, goose steps. In case it wasn't clear, he's a literal Nazi. Yeah, so they seem to want to usurp the head of the museum. Oh, hello. Don't mind me, I was just following you out. Oh, no. Not another one. Oh, Ernie.
Ernie's eyes are bulging in a peculiar way, leading you to believe he either choked, drowned, or was frightened to death.
What happened to his mustache?
Ernie's mouth gapes, though whether this occurred in his death throes or simply as a result of the corpse's position is unclear. This arm is flung out to the side as if to say, I am completely limp. Ernie's arm is draped over a tusk in a casual pose. If he weren't dead, he'd look like an ad for menswear. Ernie's suspenders are intact, which saves you from much embarrassment. Ernie's shoes are intact, yet strangely dark and damp-looking. Ernie's pants appear to be clinging somewhat to his legs.
Wonder why.
The pants are intact, but the smell emanating from them is noticeable. It's as if he took a swim in bathtub gin. The leather of Ernie's shoes are soaked through and through. The scent is an overpowering mixture of sweat, shoe polish, and alcohol. The hairs are bristled and clearly animal in origin, with a faint smell of alcohol. You pick it up and place it in your purse.
I don't want to tamper with evidence, but I'm going to take these animal hairs.
There is little to see in Ernie's mouth besides the usual teeth, tongue, hard and soft palates, and uvula. But there does seem to be an unusual amount of mucosa foam in the cheeks and throat, usually indicative of death by drowning. There's also a strange trickle of clear fluid. With obvious distaste, you sniff around the area of his mouth. The odor is one of pure alcohol.
Gross.
You look closely at Ernie's eyes, but find little except a few broken blood vessels. Despite your closest examination, you find nothing unusual about Ernie's outstretched right arm. A minute inspection of Ernie's left arm reveals nothing suspicious.
The suspenders are damp but intact and reek of alcohol or something similarly chemical.
Yeah,
dry
so.
Cleaning fluid, perhaps.
I think it's pretty clear he died in one of those preservation vats.
You look carefully for bruises or contusions around the neck, but you find nothing. That's not the...
Oop. All right. Well, this one I do feel bad about, because I liked Ernie. Seemed like a nice guy. I like how these people do not care, though. Countess and Olympia, they're just like, ho-hum, another day. Wait, where am I supposed to go again? No, I need to go to the Master's Gallery. It's always... there we go.
You are smelling like the brewery, mein Capitan. Either you've been drinking, or you've been eating too many of those grapes.
Sure, and Bigora.
Why would grapes smell like
alcohol? A little nip from his
flask there.
Now and then, doesn't he?
Used to make wine, but
personally,
still.
Personally, I do not require the drinking of the alcohol. It would impair my mental and physical skills.
Ernie Leach has been murdered!
What was that, lass?
Ernie is dead!
Dead?
So, you've finally come to us to confess, is that it?
Confess? No! I'm reporting a murder!
And you were the first one to find the body again?
Well, not really.
Well, I guess so.
There's people just
who
didn't care.
Quite a coincidence, Fräulein. I think we should be interrogating you to learn the truth!
All right,
I've
relax.
Had enough of your lies!
Calm down, Heimlich. If there's any interrogating to be done, I'll be the one who does it. Now then, lass, where did you find the body?
The Mastodon room. He's hanging from some Mastodon tusks.
Ach, he's probably just sleeping on the job.
No, I'm sure he's dead.
Well, I'll go take a look at him then. If I need to talk to you, I'll find you later.
And that's the end of Act 3. We did it! It's kind of crazy how quickly I can go through Act 3 now when, like I said, when I was a kid, it was how I spent most of the game. Just exploring, trying to find stuff.
Do we smell a promotion in the air?
Mm-hmm.
You're doing splendidly.
I think so. But that being said, before we start Act 4, which is considerably shorter than Act 3, I'm going to end the video. So you'll get to see the conclusion. I'm guessing we'll probably be done pretty quick, so maybe 3 more videos. It's a world of difference when I know exactly what I need to do, for the most part. So... thanks again for watching, everyone, and we'll see you next time on Point Click Repeat. My name is Alan, and see you then. Bye-bye.